Hello students, this answer, this question is asked many a times. Torque acting on a dipole placed in a uniform electric field. A dipole is placed in a uniform electric field and you have to calculate the torque acting on the dipole. See, dipole means a system of two equal and opposite charges, right? Separated by some finite distance of 2a. You can take the distance as d also, no problem. Let this distance be 2a. It is placed in an uniform electric field. Okay, let us say electric field. Uniform electric field means field line should be parallel and equidistant. Okay, so this is the electric field. Now electric field is from plus to minus, clear? Okay, so now positive charge will experience a force QE. Positive charge will experience a force QE in the direction of electric field. So it will experience a force QE in this direction. Negative charge will experience a force minus QE in the direction opposite to electric field. So force of minus QE. Okay, right. Fine. Now let P be the dipole moment which is directed from negative to positive. This is the dipole moment. This is E. So the angle between P and EB theta. Angle between P and EB theta. So this is your dipole. This is the center of the dipole. Electric field is in this direction, right? So because of this electric field, a positive charge will experience a force in this direction and negative charge will experience a force in this direction. So if both the forces are acting from two different points, right? One is QE and minus QE. So this will rotate. This will rotate, right? If you are applying a force from this end and in this direction from this end, so this will rotate, clear? So that will be the torque, that will be the torque which will be acting on the dipole. That is what we have been calculating, clear? Okay, so this dipole will experience a torque. Torque will be in the direction, torque is defined as R cross F. In the chapter of rotational motion you must have studied that torque is simply cross product of R and F. So this is R, this is F. So from right hand rule, R cross F, this will be the direction of torque, clear? This is R, this is F, R cross F, clear? Okay. Now torque magnitude wise can be defined as force into perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance from given reference point. From given reference point. Clear? See, now in this case, what is perpendicular distance and how we'll calculate the torque? Of course, the dipole is placed in this manner. QE force acts in this direction, minus QE acts in this direction, right? So if both the forces of same magnitude but are acting from different points, so because of this the dipole will rotate. Because of this the dipole will rotate, that means it will experience some torque. Okay, so force is QE, E is the electric field, Q is the charge. So force on positive charge is QE and it will be in this direction. Force on negative charge will be minus QE and it will be in direction opposite to electric field, right? So this is the case. This is force QE, this is force minus QE, right? The total distance is 2A. This is 2A. Okay. Now, dipole moment is in this direction. Say this distance is 2A. Electric field is in this direction. So the angle between P and E, let the angle between P and E be theta. This is 2A, right? Dipole moment is from negative to positive. This is your electric field. So the angle between P and E, this is theta, right? Okay. So this will be A, this will also be A. This is A, this is center of the dipole, right? Okay. So this will be A. A is in this direction. Dipole moment is in this direction. Electric field is in this direction, right? So this, it means this is A. This is the force, right? This angle is theta. So this will be A cos theta and this will be A sin theta, right? A, this is theta, this will be A cos theta, this will be A sin theta. So A sin theta is the perpendicular distance, clear? Because Q is in this direction. So A sin theta will be the perpendicular distance. So what is torque? Force into perpendicular distance. So torque can be written as QE into A sin theta. In the same way, here also torque will be QE into perpendicular distance. Clear? So total torque acting on a dipole can be calculated as force, which is QE, and perpendicular distance. Now this is A sin theta, right? This is A sin theta. So in the same manner, this will also be A sin theta, right? So perpendicular distance for both these forces, QE and minus QE, the perpendicular distance will be A sin theta and A sin theta. Clear? So total perpendicular distance will be 2A sin theta, right? So torque is QE into 2A sin theta. 2A sin theta is the perpendicular distance for both the charges. Fine. So torque is finally, what is Q into 2A? Q into 2A is P. So it is PE sin theta magnitude wise. Or it can be written as P cross E. This is the torque acting on a dipole placed in a uniform electric field. Right? Of course, torque acting on a dipole may or may not be zero because it depends on the angle sin theta. Right, if I am placing this dipole, right, parallel to electric field, then theta will be zero. And if theta will be zero, sine zero is zero. So in that particular case or in that particular situation, there will be no torque acting on a dipole. Clear? So you have to add this point in your answer, that torque acting on a dipole may or may not be zero. It depends on the angle. But the force acting on a dipole will always be zero. Force acting on a dipole will be zero when it is placed in a uniform electric field, because force on positive charge is QE. Force on positive charge will be QE. This will be in the direction of electric field, and force on negative charge will be minus QE, and that will be in the direction opposite to electric field. So net force acting on the dipole will be zero. So force acting on the dipole will be zero when placed in a uniform electric field. But torque acting on the dipole placed in a uniform electric field may or may not be zero. So this will be your answer for the torque acting on a dipole placed in a uniform electric field.